It is getting cold here in Germany, so I thought why not build a well-insulated chamber that I can heat up electrically and in which I then can sit inside to warm up. And yes, that was a joke, because this heating chamber will of course not be for me, but instead my four solar system batteries. You see, the problem is that those can only get charged up safely when it is over 0 degrees Celsius. And my PV system wants to play it even safer by only charging above 5 degrees Celsius. That is of course a problem, because the batteries are placed inside my concrete garage that comes with forced ventilation, which will definitely get colder than that during winter time. Now there do exist self-heating batteries that avoid this problem, but those are quite a bit more expensive. And when you want a truly massive energy storage, then I've not yet seen a self-heating one. So in this video, I will try my best to build such a heating chamber that will hopefully not require too much energy, in order to find out whether such a solution could be scaled up for a possibly bigger battery later on. Let's get started! This video is sponsored by PVCase, your go-to photovoltaic design software that can be used for ground mount installations and roof mount installations. PVCase will speed up your design process, increasing your pipeline up to 50% for large commercial PV systems and utility scale plans. Key features include 3D modeling in complex terrain, slope analysis, shading calculation, and intelligent algorithms that makes planning fast and accurate. So click the link in the video description below and start your free trial now. Now to make this big project easy to understand, let's divide it into these three segments: how to create heat, building the actual chamber, and finally the control electronics. And let's start off with creating heat, because that initially sounds simple, but it is actually quite complicated. The reason is that I wanted a big surface that can only heat up to a maximum of around 50 degrees Celsius for safety reasons. And I also wanted to power this heater directly with mains voltage to keep it all as simple and efficient as possible, so that I do not have to worry about a separate power supply. So the simplest solution of grabbing a big power resistor, slapping that onto a metal surface and powering that is pretty much out of the question, because it uses a lower voltage and it also gets too hot. Instead, I searched for heaters you can buy from the internet, in this case from AliExpress to be specific, and I think I found 4 different ones that could do the job. But long story short, the resistance of the silicone covered one as well as the heating wire was way too low. And of course, a low resistance means a higher power output when hooking up mains voltage. The result is, as you can see, a super quick heating up time as well as a too high temperature. But luckily for me, I also ordered this big terrarium heat pad, which comes with a higher resistance. And thus, after hooking it up to mains voltage, it heated up slowly and only up to 40 degrees Celsius. Perfect. Sadly though, the size of this thing was in the end too big for my heat chamber, and thus I had to switch over to my last ordered product, which was a plastic enclosed heating pad that is usually used for floor heating. And luckily for me, this thing performed pretty much the same way as the terrarium heater, meaning it is definitely suitable for my application. Only difference here is that I had to add mains voltage wires by myself. And at this point, I also have to warn you that working with mains voltage should only be done by professionals. Okay, and with that out of the way, the heating problem was solved, and it was time to build the actual chamber. For that, I firstly measured the dimensions of my batteries and checked what lumber I still had laying around. And I think these pretty generic wood laths, in combination with some plywood and OSBs should do the trick just fine. And in case you're wondering, here are their dimensions. But of course, just using wood does not hold the heat that well. Which is why I made a trip to my attic, where I still got lots of mineral wool laying around. Now this one is 5 cm thick, and my idea here is to basically double it up and thus hopefully get a good heat insulation. And luckily for me, two wood lefts stacked on top of one another are the perfect height for this insulation. So after making a truly rough sketch of how the wood construction should look like in the end, I started cutting wood lefts to size with the miter saw, stacked them up and thus created the sides for my first wood rectangle, which I then put together with more screws. After repeating this complete process to create a second rectangle for the top and bottom, I then cut more wood lefts to size and combined them to make the connection pieces for the rectangles. With the help of some wood dowels and glue, I then put this all together and thus got myself the basic structure of my heat chamber. So next, I put in some reinforcement beams for the middle section as well as the lower section, and used that in order to firstly install the lower OSB floor. At this point, I also scrapped my initial building plans and went freestyle, in order to somehow mount plywood to create the inner walls for the batteries. And by the way, using my new bandsaw was a huge help here. But anyway, after this was finally done, I moved on to the middle or upper section, where I pretty much repeated all the steps from the lower section. And with that complete, I got all the inner walls done, meaning it was time to cut the mineral wall to size, push it into the cavities, and close it all up on the outside with another OSB. If you want to do something similar, then I would highly recommend wearing gloves and a respiratory protection, because you do not want to touch or breathe in this stuff. And as soon as all insulation was in place and wheels got added to the bottom, I gotta say that I was very happy with the chamber so far. All that was missing now was a door, but that was pretty easy to create at this point, because it was basically the same building technique I used before. Except that this time I also added a handle, hinges to mount the door to the chamber, and finally the snapping thingies that keep the door closed. And there you have it, my lovely crafted heating chamber, which was still not done though, because at this point I realized that there was a way too big gap between the door and chamber. So to fix that, I added an inner and outer ceiling line. And with this part finally complete, we can move on to the control electronics. Now all we need here is basically a temperature sensor, a relay to turn on or off our heater, and a microcontroller that monitors the temperature and then turns on the relay. And yes, I had all these components laying around in my lap, but I wanted to be lazy this time, and thus got myself this pre-made commercial solution. After hooking it up to mains voltage, it seems to measure the temperature accurately enough with its sensor. And after connecting a light bulb as a load and fine adjusting the temperature on and off thresholds, the system works perfectly fine and is suitable for my application. That means it was time to finish this all, which I did by mounting the control circuit to the top, cutting my heater to size, adding wires, securing it to the inner door of my chamber, guiding the wires to the top, for which I previously drilled some holes, and finally doing all the mains voltage wiring inside a distribution box and securing the temperature sensor inside. And just like that, my project was more or less done, and it was time for first proper tests at a room temperature of 13 degrees Celsius that I wanted to increase up to 20°C. So I closed everything up and did a time lapse. But sadly, the only analog clock I have failed pretty much at the start. So you have to believe me that it only took 20 minutes to reach that temperature. And while doing that, the system drew around 32 watts and required a total of 0.012 kilowatt hours, which cost me like nothing. And best of all, the chamber dropped down to not even 15°C after 1 hour without heating, meaning the insulation seems to do its job just fine. Of course, with the batteries inside, the heat up time and energy required will change, and I will actually have to see over time how well this works with the batteries and whether new problems arise with the setup. But with the new battery poles on top for now, everything works perfectly fine, and I hope you enjoyed the show and maybe got inspired to make something on your own. If so, consider supporting this show on Patreon so that I can keep making videos. And as always, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!